Hello, my woolly friends. It is I, Ash Smyrna from Nouveau Fiber Arts, and I am doing a new and improved how to wash wool tutorial that has much better lighting. These are four gorgeous, super fine border luster fleeces I got from a friend of mine, and I'm going to wash them in the washing machine, and it's totally awesome and easy. So watch how we do this. When I purchase my fleeces, they're already skirted and they have no vegetable matter in them, so I can just throw them into the washing machine. However, if you do not know if your fleece is skirted, dump out the bag and pull out anything that's really dirty and has poop in it, because if you throw in some poop in your washing machine with the rest of your wool, it's going to get your whole bag of wool dirty. This is an example of wool that I am not putting in the wash. It's very short staple and there's a little bit of poo in it, and so I just went ahead and took this little bit out. I'm turning my wash machine to hot and I'm just gonna bring it around to light or whatever. All I want to do is fill it up with hot water. Starting to fill up. Regarding water temperature, some people say it should always be over 140 degrees, and for fine wools like Merino and Cormo and Ravulé, you'll want it to be over 160 degrees. And while it's filling up with water, we're going to take some average dish soap. We do not want a soap that has bleach or bleach alternative, because that can damage the wool. And I'm going to put about a cup and a half or so of soap into this wash. I want enough so that the water feels slimy. And my water feels very soapy, very slimy, so I'm going to start putting the wool in. As I put the wool in, I want to make sure that I shake it out so all the locks are separated. You may have a fleece that is more attached to itself, where all the locks are interconnected. Look at this, isn't that just beautiful? Take a moment and just drink that in. They just fall apart. All my wool is now in the wash, and I just need to press it under the water very gently. Make sure that it all goes under the water. And my water isn't super, super, super hot. But if your water is hot, you can use a potato masher to press the wool down. And I'm not agitating it, I'm just making sure that it's all under the water, being really gentle. 15 minutes has passed, so here's where it gets tricky. If I put the lid down, it'll start agitating. So I'm going to prop the lid up, bring this over to spin, pull it out, and then when I put this lid down, all the water will spill out. Now all the water has been spun out, and you can see that it's already getting really white and beautiful. So I'm just going to put this through a rinse. So I'm going to fluff up these locks a little bit, just to separate them. And I'm going to put in another, start the water again and fill it up over these locks and let it soak for another 15 minutes. The rinse water is in and you can tell it's clear because you can see in between the locks right there. So I'm just going to let it spin out. My favorite thing about this technique is this spin cycle spins almost all the water out, so your drying time is cut at least in half, and it's just less messy overall.
And here it is with the water spun out, and I'll pull it out so you can see the end result. And here we are. This is what it looks like after. And that is a quick tutorial on how to wash wool fleeces in the washing machine.